Bottom of the barrel, hey. Bottom of the barrel, hey. Where we always hey. Feel so tall. Bottom of the barrel, hey. Bottom of the barrel, hey. The barrel is only hey. 2 foot small.
Sounds about right. Sounds about right.
Oh my god, welcome back to Bottom of the Barrel.
Hey!
Me too. I thought for sure that was happening.
Yeah, we got COVID tests today, boys. Cheers to that.
Yeah.
Hey, we can make out.
Yeah. We don't know if we passed yet. Mm. Oh, but guess we're all the same.
We did it. That's what counts, really.
Either none of us have it,
or all of us have it.
All have it.
And so, regardless, we're good being super close now.
Yeah.
I like sure. this. Feels good.
We're good being at the bottom of the barrel.
At the bottom of the barrel.
One day we'll have a barrel. We can be the bottom.
I swear to God, guys.
Right now we're just in a fucking forest.
We got a beautiful forest behind us. That's a bad forest.
Yeah, I know. We're here filming a TV show, finally.
Vancouver.
This is why we're not
British Columbia.
Anywhere special.
Who are we talking about stepping on lions today?
Canada.
I was like, did I
sunny day today.
If you guys
rented a boat.
If you guys don't like inside jokes, do not listen to this one because
inside.
That's all. Okay, I got there.
We did rent a boat with a barbecue on it. We just never got to sit on it.
Yeah. But he's coming through. He's coming through tomorrow.
So we're doing it tomorrow.
This is Alex Boyer. Hey. I know he doesn't say much, but he's here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good. They know.
Good
they
intro.
Know. You guys.
Yeah.
This is fucking fun. This is where it's at right now. Like, I know to them, everybody at home right now looks like we're sitting at any table.
Yeah.
In anywhere in the world.
We're like, not anywhere in the world. We're in a specific place.
We're in a specific place and we're here. This has been
perfect. Six months in the making.
6 months, dude.
6 months, dude, in the making, nonstop meetings and everything. Yeah. And a few days from now, we're going to start filming our pilot to the show that we're creating.
Yeah, dude. And it's 6 months for me and Chris, but it's only 3 months for you guys.
Yeah,
you know, there's something to say about this morning, how I felt, is I got woken up with a firecracker in my room at 7 a.m. By 7:30, we're walking on a street going to get breakfast, and I'm pumped.
Yeah.
I'm sitting there being like, and I'm tired, they woke up hungover, they woke up with fireworks. Usually it'd be at a cottage or something, it's like, oh, fuck off, let me just sleep. But I was like walking, I was like, feeling this.
Oh, yeah. Know?
Like, we're here for a reason.
Yeah.
Big things are coming, people.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Big energy.
Big energy.
Oh,
yeah,
man. Lots of tricks coming.
It's going to be good times.
We should call it Magic Impossible.
So bad.
I want to call it Mind Freak.
Wait, Magic Dudes?
The Magic Dudes.
Trick Heads.
Remember, that was one, eh? Right. That one was Fools of Magic.
Yeah.
Or Magic Fools.
Oh, Close Up Kings.
Oh,
was that the first one? Ramsay, Chris Ramsay experience?
Oh, the Chris Ramsay project. Chris Ramsay project.
That's basically what it is.
Street friends.
Yeah. Every time I get a good idea for this show, they're like, well, let's Chris do that one. I'm like, okay. He's doing all of the shots so far. I'm like, yeah, but you're gonna hold the sound boom. And Alex, you're gonna do the editing.
Yeah, exactly.
And Eric, you're gonna have the clapper that says scene one.
Oh, I'm confident enough now. I'm confident enough to say that this is gonna be a revolutionary magic show.
I think so.
I agree too.
Oh yeah.
It's never been done or seen before. Yeah. And we're just dumbing it down.
You guys ever seen a magician puke on TV?
You've seen magician's pants?
Oh, yeah. Coming.
Hey, so listen to this.
Okay.
Nick, one of the producers, one of the first things he said was, we just had a meeting now, we got out of, and he said,
did you guys have a meeting?
But he said, literally, he said this, on paper, if we shoot everything that's on paper, we already have a successful show.
Mm.
So that's all we have to do. And now we add into the mix,
good stuff.
You know,
Alex's accent.
Alex's hair, lines.
My hair.
His hair.
Yep. His air.
His air.
My hair.
My hair.
What's wrong with hair?
My favorite story about Alex, you know, is we tease Alex because he has a Quebecer accent, Mr. Ronson the H's, whatever. But the other day we're at my house, and it's a big thing about the Quebecer accent is all the and. Right?
Yeah.
And he's like, we're just gonna go and we're gonna do hearts and crafts. And the Quebecers always say art, they don't want to pronounce the H, but for once, he was actually pronouncing the H.
Yeah, they get it backwards.
But we're gonna do hearts and crafts. I just like, I'm an emotional magician, I like it from the art. I'm like, we're gonna do hearts and crafts.
You can say, look, I will spray the air spray in the hair.
The air spray in the hair.
I'm like, just switch them around. You know how to say both. We know you know how to say both of them. So you might as well just do it the right, you know, say the right thing.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Makes me so happy.
That's pretty funny though. Oh, the funny, my funniest Alex story was that we were on a Zoom call, one of these meetings, and Alex is like, you're like, oh yeah, I'm like the smooth talker, I'm good with ladies and all this. And then he says like, he goes like this, he's on camera and he goes, because it's in my gene.
No, it's in my gene, you know? No, no, it's in my gene.
And he goes, no, oh, he's in, oh, he goes, yeah, it's in my gene. Not my genes, my gene.
I'm so happy you find that funny.
And I'm like, dude, oh my god, it's the same word. So funny.
Yeah, he tried too hard. He ended up fucking it up.
Yeah, but he was trying so hard.
Proud
of finding a pun.
Yeah.
But that was great, Alex.
I love you guys so much.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Well, the best one for Alex for that too was me. That yeah. I like when we were all sitting around. He's like, gonna post something. He's gonna post something on Instagram. And he's like, is it photography or photographies? Oh, and we're all like, in, we're like photographies. He's like, okay. And
I really fell in love with the world of photographies.
Yeah, he put that on his Instagram as a caption.
Like, IES at the end of
the He had it right too. Oh my god. He's like, is this how you spell it? I'm like, no, it's photographies.
And I was so proud of this post too, man. It was my first like great post of like a beautiful picture of deck of cards.
Should we start talking about something fun and relevant that people will care about?
Sure. Live on everything. Chris has got drinks coming. We're good.
Nobody watches this.
Oh my god. This is the best fucking team we got going, man. They watch everything. They love it all. What is this? This is bigger. Can I have the tall one? The 1818. That's a wonderful year.
What's the story I was telling earlier?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Getting free shit being a magician. You got a bottle or something? That's right, fucking crazy,
right.
Man.
So I gotta give a shout out to Chris Ramsay because what did Murphy's Magic 5 years ago? 4 years ago?
Yeah.
5 years.
Five years ago,
at the table or Murphy's. Is it Murphy's?
Is that a table?
It was a Murphy's at the table lecture. A thing for magicians where you get to go give your ideas, whatever. I had the choice between Gregory Wilson, one of my idols, and Chris Ramsay. I'm like, Chris Ramsay, I didn't know you that well. We chilled at conventions. We knew we liked each other. Anyways, pick Chris for the host. Go to Sacramento. That night, he's like, we're gonna go out. And I'm like, yeah, let's go. He's like, you bringing magic? And in my head, like, that part of my life is done.
Yeah.
I'm not doing magic at a bar to impress girls. Like, it's so. Yeah. And Chris is like, yeah, he's got the good tricks. He has the cutting edge tricks. He's still like, what are you talking about? We're going to go out there and go to impress people. We're going to go,
you know. Yeah, get some free drinks.
Get some free drinks and, like, get the bartenders. I'm like, ah, that's cringe, dude. We get to the bar. Cringe Ramsay, his pockets full of magic, and he's like, you got shit? I'm like, yeah. He's like, let's go to that table over there. Those three girls, you know? And I'm like, no, I'm good. He's like, well, I'm going. He goes, performs, amazing magic. The girls freak out. He's like, my friend's a magician there too, and I'm standing there like, and now it's my turn. So I go up to the table. As before my first trick, I'm performing. Three guys, big, tough-looking army
it's
guys.
Just to make, I mean, to just also to add on what you're saying, like, this is like, I mean, Eric's been in a rut for like a while when we did this.
Right.
Like you were like.
Yeah, I wasn't keen or I didn't want
to. So it took everything for you to come over to that table.
I was ready though.
Yeah.
So I go and as soon as I start, these three big guys, army looking guys, you know, one Puerto Rican guy looking Jack, the other guy push-ups all day, every day. They sit down with these girls and I'm like, and then Chris is like, so I perform, but it just so happens that we're just friends, they go, whatever. So then we're chilling with these girls, everything's going well, and then they ask us these cliche questions that we've been asked as magicians all our lives. You know, is it good for pick up girls, or do you guys get free shit, or can you really read people's minds, or guess people's PIN numbers, win the lottery, shit like that. And she's like, do you guys ever get free shit? I'm like, oh. So Chris is like, yo, well, sometimes. And I'm in my head, I'm like, ugh. And then we decide to take it to an after party. We go to a liquor store. Mm. And I decide to turn the cashiers. We're still trying to kind of impress people around us a little bit. And I was in the mood that Chris was like, magic is a gift. You have to give it to people. Shame on you for knowing all these tricks that amazes people and keep it to yourself. Like, fuck you, you know? What the fuck? Share it. Yeah. So I decide to take the cashiers. I'm like, no, you don't believe that? Shame on you for making someone laugh or
knowing
you can make someone laugh.
Carry on, I'll talk
okay, sorry, sorry. So I get to the cashier, I take her 20, change it to, or take 100.
You take 100.
I take her 100, rip it. I see 100 in the cash, lend me that. She lends it, he lends it to me, the guy. And I'm like, rip it, memorize the serial number, put it back together. He's blown away. He gives us a free bottle. He's like, you know what? This one's on me.
In front of everybody.
Gives us a bottle of Jack in front of those girls, in front of the guys, everybody. And we're like, so we're like, at this point, we're looking like, you know. But it was that moment. It's a gift, and what we have, what we've been studying for years, is something so special. At a drop of a dime, you can amaze somebody. You can make them laugh. You can scar them.
Surprise them
for life. Yeah, they'll remember that shit.
I mean, come on, like, I mean,
All right.
Eric, your punchline should recur a little bit more often.
Yeah, Eric's like, so I woke up that morning, brushed my teeth, went to the fridge.
My parents
out of blueberries.
So I had to go to the store.
I was out of blueberries, too.
Hey, cheers, boys.
Bye, cheers.
Oh, fuck, I'm so drunk.
Cheers. The Jody's. Jody. Emma's going to
do something. I believe you're right about Sharon Magic way back 10 minutes ago when you were talking about that. Mm-hmm. But I also think, like, sometimes it goes on too long. Some people are like, stop.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Like, no one to quit. No one to quit.
Yes. Mm. I don't know if you're referring to my story or an overperforming situation.
Yeah, no, this is more like.
I'm talking about choosing not to perform. Yeah. Be like, oh, either it's beneath me, I'm shy, I'm not up to date, they're not going to like it, compared to, like, the exaggeration of that performance.
Yeah, what's the real reason you don't want to perform? And that's probably like,
you're also
probably not self-confident in that moment because it's been such a long time that you're looking at yourself being like, okay, if I don't deliver, I'm gonna feel like an ass.
I'll tell you right now what it is, and I know the exact answer. Is when I'm in that situation, it's not I'm out, I'm rusty, I know at a drop of a dime, it's I don't want people to think that that's my go-to. Mm. He always does this, and that's all. That's my worth.
So 100%. You know. Okay. Wait. I fully agree with that, and I will add to that the fact that, like, whenever I go to, like, a wedding or something, I'm just a guest. I'm not like a guest of importance of any kind. I'm just a random guest. People are always like, "Why do some magic?" I'm like, "Nope."
Exactly.
I'm like, I'm about to make this about me.
Yeah.
That's their day.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, people will love it for sure.
True.
But
true.
I don't have an idol. Yeah, when I go, I'm gonna be like on a table throwing fucking flash paper for no reason and just doing weird shit.
I have a story to tell you guys and I'll reduce it, okay? I was with
my girlfriend Emma's
friends were getting engaged. She takes me to this Brooklyn engagement party where it's at an ice cream shop, super hipster. We're there and she's like, "Hey, you wanna show them a trick?" I'm like, "Great." I show people a trick in a corner, do a bill switch, everyone's like, start reacting, and she's like, Okay. She pushes my hands away.
Dude,
like,
her pussy was so wet. She
I took out a mop, and I was just swiffering.
She was like, no.
Loop.
And she was gonna fall.
But she didn't realize how
to drown in her own pussy juice.
She didn't realize how people were gonna, you know. And she told me to stop, and I told her afterwards, I'm like, hey.
Yeah.
Don't, I told her in front of
you. You ever seen a squirter try and sit and start doing this?
I'm like, don't tell me to perform. Yeah. And then I'm like, I change it to 100. It's her 10. I have to change it.
Because then you feel like you're just,
I'm like, don't tell me to perform, which I wouldn't have in the first place. Yeah. And then say, shh, I don't want to.
Yeah, exactly.
See, like, you know.
Yeah.
Let's get this big guy in the podcast.
Scotch and a wine, baby.
Come say hi.
Scotch and a wine bottle.
I like this a lot. It's
very fun.
It's fancy, but not too fancy.
It opens it up. Yes. The guy that we're looking at through our window right now does not work out.
That's an easy thing to say.
He's never done push-ups. Oh, and his wife just came out.
There we go. They are definitely a couple. Chris Ramsay! Puzzle. Do you like puzzles? Hey! Do you like
Eric!
Do you like puzzles?
Sit down.
Jesus.
He's a fucking...
That's his wife?
Oh.
Those windows are open.
That one was bomb.
That window, like...
Well, you should be that famous. That's not my problem.
Oh my god! Because
has it been 40? It's only been 15 fucking minutes.
I think that we should call it there. We got shit to do. Right?
No way. Alex, you got a story you want to
say? We can do the dildo race.
Oh, dildo race!
Do it. It's a vibrator race. You fucking idiot!
All right.
Well, one day you're gonna pull out a dildo race. I'm gonna be so happy. Should you take your course and just put it on a slant? Loop them up.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's pretty good.
I bought it just for this.
I have two here, but my batteries are dead. I just tried them. I was going to do it live.
Okay.
So, the winner of last week was Sage Warden.
And
Nick Greck.
Hey!
Good job guessing it right. You guys are up for the vibrator race today. The lie was me siphoning gas. We were telling things we'd done illegally when we were in our youth, and I've never siphoned gas. Dad, you told a couple things you did.
What was mine?
Shoplifting or something?
Oh yeah, I used to steal...
Or tongue punching a fart hole, something like that.
No. That's, I don't, that, last time I did that was way over there.
apparently.
No, there's, I was talking about taking the tags off of like cheap things and putting them on expensive things and then just paying for them.
Light
so
hack.
It didn't feel like shoplifting. Just feel like
that's death.
Big discounts.
Light hack.
So,
Eric, do you want pink or purple?
Purple.
Put some stakes on
it. Alex?
Pink.
Okay, Alex and Eric, you're betting. You're betting each other.
Yeah.
Okay.
Loser chugs.
Now.
Actually, Chris, pink. I
want
to
say. Do you want Nick or do you want Sage?
Wait.
Nick.
Wes,
Nick.
Can I just take this moment? I want to tell you this moment. It's
so good interrupting.
No, it makes sense.
Nick, you're pink. Sage, you're purple.
Let's do it, Nick.
Alex knows who's here for. Eric, you know you got purple.
Eric's purple.
Purple.
Sage. Purple Sage. Ready to go?
So excited for this.
In three. In two. In one.
Five. Oh!
Nick just wins.
Go ahead, Nick, the fucking do it, Nick!
Oh, shit! Oh.
Yeah.
Not look like that's the way that was gonna go.
Alex, the whole thing, baby. No.
You lost that.
You chugged this.
I chugged this.
Oh, you think it's so drunk?
Yeah, let's go. Congratulations, Eric.
Ready? Three, two, one. All of it. Let's go.
Yeah.
One chug. Let's go. Drink it.
Go.
Pour it in your face.
What are you doing?
Just in your gullet.
Take everything in. Oh,
that's
my
it.
God.
Suck it.
No.
Oh, get off.
Keep bottom going. Of
what
the
are
barrel.
You doing?
Bottom of the barrel.
Oh, my God.
Bottom.
There you go.
Not even on camera.
What a waste.
Congratulations, Sage. You won.
Congratulations, Alex. You just had a free beer.
Yeah. Comment will pin you. Sorry for the chaos, everybody. But that's what we do now. Holy shit, that was good. Alex, you did a wonderful job. How'd you piss yourself?
Neighbor number three came out.
There
we go. Who we got here?
Other polygamous.
That's Len.
Polygamous.
Oh, what a chaos. What
good times, boys.
I know.
Can we talk about the prank we're about to go do, or no?
Does it matter? Good.
I mean, it's...
It doesn't matter.
I feel like it's an okay prank.
It's not good to write home about. It's good to vlog. I would say that we're going to we gotta do two truths and a lie at some point before we go. And
it is kind of weird, the prank, though, because like it's not like crazy.
It's just funny.
All
right, you guys talk about this later. I'm gonna do my podcast.
Yeah.
I do want to say that I'm one step closer today. One step closer to getting to moving next to Chris. I've had a big milestone.
Yeah.
I think it might even happen. I think we might even get closer, which means we're gonna get a big old barrel. I'm very excited about that. And we are gonna
get a big old barrel.
Big old barrel.
And we're gonna sit at the bottom of it.
Big old barrel, ball and barrel.
Does that sound like?
Oh my God. So, Eric, what's your best accent?
I am horrible at accents.
This is great. Can we go all the way around? Okay, do any accent right now. No, we have to guess what it is.
Give me an accent.
मैं बहुत अच्छे तरीके से हिंदी बोल सकता हूँ.
Wow. That's not an accent. That's like actual words.
That's a really good Japanese accent.
Did you speak real
Indian? That's great. That's great Russian.
Is that one when you were in the
I can't do accents.
Do us anything.
Don't be racist.
I can do
it. I'll tell you what I do right now. You look at this because you will lose your mind.
You did Alex.
The record accent.
That's I was going to say, I can do a French Canadian try to speak
English. Yeah, can you do something else though? What was the English guy sounding to you?
English guy sounding to me? Like English.
I want
to
hear Alex do an English.
Yeah. English, like in London or
like,
something.
Yeah,
right. Right.
In Blackpool, if we go to Blackpool, they all sound like, hey, what are they on phone? What is there? Oh, what are they about? Beer?
That's not bad.
Right?
You did way better than I did.
He said, this man is honorable and I'll give my daughter to him to be married.
Yeah.
I'll trade him for my beer. Wes, let's go. We heard English on your video recently.
Yeah, I was doing that. But that was like posh English, which was hard. I was like really struggling with that.
Can you do the Cockney?
What are we going to do for work, love?
What are we going to do for work?
What are we going to do for work?
What the fuck are you going to do for work?
Yeah.
Do you know who the fuck I am? Do ya?
You fucking pussy old.
Do you know who the fuck I am?
Can you show my finger on me right now?
With the body movements?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you can do this for sure.
I am this town. I'm bouncing heads off the canvas. Me and Dana White. Dana, listen, put me in, let me fight. Hit him right in the head.
Look at the kid watching you right
please,
now.
Please stop.
It's so
strange.
What do you mean, waving at the kid?
Yeah, it's so weird.
Yeah.
You know what I do?
This window's ruining everything.
To what you guys
that was great. That was great. Eric ruined a perfectly good accent bit by staring at kids.
Yeah, 100%. We're in here, we're doing work, and there's...
Is it smoking?
What does the German sound like? Because that's your heritage.
Ah, it's a German, yeah. I just give you a German accent where I close the blinds so that Eric is not completely distracted and has a hard on. You know, he's got the boner, so we have to hide the children from Eric's.
That girl is way less awkward than a dad watching you close the blinds after.
Yeah, after.
Yeah, 100%.
We're working. We're trying to get a podcast done.
So I always
jeez,
you guys are an unholy.
No, but like the whole time,
paranoid.
No, half of us are up there looking at the people coming outside, and we're not paying attention to the podcast. Yeah. It just makes it weird.
Podcast is very important.
We're here to do the podcast.
Yeah. Listening to you guys,
man. If you want to go look at children, just go outside. Just go. It's fine. You don't have to stay here
with us. It's dinner time soon. They'll be in with their parents.
Eric's the only one I know that like actively went shopping for an ice cream truck. They're like, why do you want that? There's no ice cream in it. He's like, oh, that's fine. What? Too far. All right. Okay, grow your mustache.
It's not too far.
It's fine. Got glasses to look more distinguished. Doesn't matter. What happened? Okay. Well, good job, everybody. I don't know what we're talking about now.
All right, so we did the accents.
Yeah, that was fun. We could have done more. Would have been great.
I feel like the accents were. That was a really good question. I think I said this on the podcast. I'm not sure, but like one of my favorite things to do is like when I go into like a fucking foreign country is pretend I speak the accent when I go buy stuff like at a corner store. And it's super fucking...
Because the accent is in your ear the whole time.
And you also get away with it. You feel like a spy, right? You're like, morning. Good, yeah? I'll have a crumpet tea and crumpet, please.
Oh, accent's kind of funny.
Where are you from? Up north here. I'm just from the Iberian Donovan.
It's the inflection. It doesn't matter what you say. Yeah, it's where you're like throwing that.
Oh. And then at the end you're like, oh, my family moved a lot. So
I moved around quite a bit. So I lived in Canada for a while.
Well, I used to always tell a story on stage. It was like in Australia, about being in Australia. And I'd always get people like, I posted one on the internet a while ago. And then people were like, like 4:10, you switched to being Kiwi. Like you're doing pretty good Australian, and you just switch to being from New Zealand, and you stay there.
Yeah, and then you can tell the difference.
Yeah, and I can tell, but like I guess when I start talking, one or two words switched me.
Yeah.
Because that's all it takes when you're trying to do an accent. If you cling on to certain words that get you going, or at least I do, and then when I hit one of those, I'm fucked. And now I'm off to the right. I can't even.
But
it's like trying to hum a different song.
But there's tricks, if I said that here. How Australians say no. If you want to learn how to say no, Eric, just say N-O-R.
Nor.
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 Really?
Nor.
Really?
That's how they say
it. Nor.
Nor. Nor. I don't want to go to...
They say yes.
Nor.
Nor.
There you go. Wow. Nor.
Dude, you actually have a little bit when you said it. I'm like, whoa, you might be with that.
He's got a lot of noise.
Yeah, I just came back from New Zealand for my buddy's wedding, and one night, first night there, he's moved there.
Is that when you called us when you were on ayahuasca?
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
He just moved there. He moved there 10 years ago. So he made a whole new group of friends. But we're his friends, we're like 20 years deep, right? So now it's like two groups of friends merging, and the first night, there's me and this guy there, and I have a strong personality. He has a strong personality, and we're both wasted, and we're sitting there. And I'm like, and I'm trying to be friendly. I'm like, yo, dude, do you remember that? And he's like, and he gave me attitude, and I'm giving my attitude back. And at one point, we're butting heads all night. He's like, you sound like such a hick. You sound to me like blah blah blah. You know, like the guy in The Simpsons, like blah, 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 the what's it, Cletus? Yeah, like, well, I'm gonna break your back and run. I'm like, dude, the same. He's like,
no, bro, Jeremy, I'll go, I'll go, I'll go.
I'm like, you sound the same to me. He's like, no, you sound like, ding, 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 ding. Like, yeah, the same. The whole night, and we wouldn't stop. But
he said you sounded like that?
He sounded like a hick. I'm like, he sounded literally like, you're not sure I'll draw a drawing, boy, you know, like, boy. I'm like, I have no idea what you're saying. You sound like a hick. I'm like, you say, he's like, you know that guy in the fucking Simpsons, Cletus? Like, just like, lang. I'm like, same. And like, we were on fucking,
oh my
the
God.
Whole night just looking at each other like,
and you guys fucked,
stupid. I mean, we were...
That's a lot of special attention you got through. Yeah. That's a lot of special attention.
A lot.
When you're describing that, I'm hard as a rock.
Did you sleep with it?
Oh my God.
Is that my beer?
Yeah. That's Alex's beer.
It's not my beer.
Yeah, you go.
Just fucking, I got it.
It would have been amazing. That would have been amazing. They would have subscribed for that.
No.
If they're watching this, they're already subscribed.
Yeah.
No one who isn't subscribed has made it this far.
Thank you.
100%.
Oh, we've been killing it, actually, by the way. Yeah. Thanks for, last video I asked people to go to iTunes and write a review.
Yeah.
And nobody did it. Not one person.
What?
We didn't change once.
We have a boatload of reviews, though. We've got like a ton of reviews.
Oh, we have a ton of reviews, but since I asked, it didn't go up not even once.
Guys, come on.
Yeah, dude. Well, there's a difference because I only check the Canadian and American Canadian difference, so there might be other Americans.
You know what's funny, though?
I check every other.
We get like our second biggest demographic is the UK.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Because there's a famous comedian who has the same name as me.
But spelled correctly.
And so that, like, 100%, and he has a podcast and everything, he's super popular. So 100%, yeah, like, some of that trickle down fame. Is sustaining
bottom of the barrel.
He cheers it out.
Chris Ramsay, thank you.
The real Chris Ramsay.
Kill it out there.
Keep killing it. I actually want to, like, I've never even heard of him. Like,
TDF. He's funny, man. I've watched some of his shit. He's pretty good.
TDF all day.
The real Chris
down fame.
Trickle
down. That's a great podcast name.
Trickle
down. Alex, what's your middle name?
My middle name?
Yeah.
Middle name?
You're just Alex Boyer?
Yeah.
Alexander?
No, you're not.
No?
Are you Alexander?
Wait. No, you're not.
Show me your license. Middle name.
You're probably like Joseph.
That's
my only. What do you mean?
On your passport. Alex Boyer?
Yeah, there you go. Alex Boyer.
I promise you, we call your mom right now.
This is a fucking fake.
Alex, you have a middle name. We call your mom right now. You have a middle name. Call her.
Call her.
Call her.
Call
her. Call your mom.
I'll call her.
Call her.
I got her number.
You see?
She's already calling.
She's in her group chat.
Wait.
She's in her group chat.
Call home sweet home.
But Alex, it blows my mind that you don't even think that's a possibility.
Yes. Wait.
Everyone has three names.
Yeah, but Martin or Joseph.
Right, wait. Cut to
Martin or Joseph. Martin's my. It's gonna be Martin or Joseph.
That's a middle name.
Pointed towards there.
Just put it on the table. She'll hear you.
Yeah, but it's funny if I hold it up.
Come on, Lucy.
It's like who wants to be.
Yeah, we're good.
Hey, Mom, I have to ask you something. What's my middle name?
Middle name?
Yeah.
And it's Martin, I think.
Martin! There we go. Merci, Lucy.
Love you.
Okay,
we'll call you back.
Bye.
We'll call you back.
Oh,
please. So,
stop everything. If you are 28 years old and you don't know your own middle name, I would love to hear this in the comments.
Kill your pets.
I just stole Alex's
That
word.
Is fucking amazing.
Did you for real?
Did you for real?
Yeah.
What?
I literally did feel it.
That's amazing.
All right, well, Martin, Alex Martin.
So my middle name is Martin that I'm never going to use and I've never used. That's so
hey, Marty!
It's crazy.
Marty's a fucking...
Alex Martin Joseph. Usually it's like the...
Dude, Marty's a legend.
Alex, that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about the fact that 30 seconds ago, we're like, what's your middle name?
What do you mean? I don't have a middle name. Okay, yeah, I don't have a middle name, but I have a middle name in like church thing.
Okay.
You know?
Okay. I'm saying when we said middle name, we're like,
no.
Okay, we're gonna
oh, yeah, middle name.
Doesn't matter.
You guys are having a marital dispute now.
Exactly. Oh, doesn't really matter. Listen, don't make this about middle names. What's funny here is that, can you imagine how different it would be to be addressing him as Martin or Marty? Think about that for a second. Think back on your entire friendship with him and how different the dynamics would be if it was like, hey, Marty's coming over. Just look at him. He looks like a Marty. Now he's starting to look like a Marty.
Yeah.
What's your real name?
Terrence.
What?
This guy's a gangster? His real name's Clarence. Clarence lives at home with both parents. And Clarence's parents has a real good marriage.
What's your middle name? Daniel, that was just funny.
Daniel. I'm my dad's name.
I think Daniel Wes Barker has a better ring to it than Wes Daniel Barker.
Yeah, but Daniel Wes is a fucking musician who was pretty popular.
Is it?
Yeah.
Really wasn't that popular.
Sure.
Popular. Yeah, ask anyone.
But is it Clarence or Terrence?
Clarence.
Terrence.
Yeah.
Terrence.
Terrence.
Yeah, like
Terry.
Terrence. I mean.
Wow.
Hey.
So you're
Gil?
Gil?
Yeah.
Because my godfather.
So Gil.
Yeah.
Aaron Gil.
EGL, Eagle.
So what's your middle name?
Write your comment below!
Let us do it. Yeah, please. Yeah.
Alright.
How about your name is Road Cannon.
So how about this? This week, instead of two truths, one lie, You're gonna find the two cringiest middle names.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, and cool. And they'll go head to head on a vibrator race.
But it has to be true. Yeah.
And
whoever does it really, like, we there's no way we can verify that.
Next week, whoever finishes second, get another bag of coffee because they're back on sending me a bunch of coffee.
Oh, sick.
Get a bag of coffee.
I'd get to try second coffee.
Oh, it was okay, but now they got a dark roast, which I think is fucking great.
So now it's even
now, up to second. Now I want to push it. Okay. Before I was like, fuck those guys. Now I'm like, yeah.
I love the brand fucking just like,
yeah. I'm like, yeah, 421 Brewhouse, but now I'm like, yeah. So I'm back on board. So, yeah, next week, finish second. That's the best way to go.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I love it.
Pick awesome. The fiber that dies. We got to go do a bunch of shit. This has been, I hope it's been fun for us, so that's all that matters.
I mean, we've only been rolling 33 minutes.
Oh, thank God. We're
never
going to
post this.
Oh, okay.
Of course it is.
I thought you guys were winding up.
No, dude. Oh, my God. Right now. I'm gonna roll a joint. Can
I? Like Joe Rogan when I can tell he's done with somebody.
He was like, you can do what you want.
You're in Canada. It's legal.
Yeah, of course, man.
It's legal. Of course. I'm gonna change
Okay, pants. Eric wears these fucking nude colored shorts all the time. He's wearing them down. Every time I'm like, why?
Salmon.
Yeah. Like, they do not look good.
NCS.
And you always look. They always look naked.
McCall, too.
Yeah, McCall. I told him before we're on the production call, he hops out of the vehicle. The network's like, whoa, is he naked? We're like, no, his shorts just look like his ass. Like, they're so.
NCS, baby.
New color shorts. Eric's the master of that. He's only messed up once in 5 years since I know him. He can abbreviate anything.
Fuck yeah.
You know those people that can talk backwards? Those people freak me. You guys ever seen that shit? Yeah. They say any word
backwards? No, but I've met some people, and you know who you are if you see this out there.
It's great.
But they pretend they do it.
Oh.
You can't, even sometimes when I do the acronym thing, like initial things, and I say it, and people are like, even my girlfriend's like, and sometimes I'm wrong. And she's like, it's so hard for them to, you know,
come. Oh, because I've been impressed before, and I'm getting lied to. Chris has got a very serious call here. Chris is a very important man. Comment below how much money you think Chris makes every month, too. Let's see what those guests are.
Please do.
I would love to read some of those out next time, so yeah. Please, sweet baby Jesus.
No, but he did buy us a six-pack. He did buy us a six-pack.
He did buy, yeah, he paid.
He did give us a six-pack.
He paid today, so that's pretty good.
How much did breakfast cost? And lunch, actually.
$77 for breakfast.
And lunch?
More than a six-pack.
$230.
So you made more than that this month? I'm pretty sure the TV show's paying for that. No? Is that you?
Okay, I'm not going to go to them with that.
Okay, good. I don't even know what
ask that.
I have a bunch of questions in my computer for all this.
Those were good.
Yeah. Ask us another question.
Dude, you hit me off guard with that shit. I was like, whoa.
Well, those ones are on my head.
Oh, my God. Alright, I got one.
Alright, let's go.
I don't. I just kind of hide myself up. Yeah,
hide
myself
up.
I knew it right away.
Fuck.
Oh no, I deleted the things I thought we were... Okay, never mind.
Oh, good job. What,
Okay. Did you want vape, guy? What do you want vape, man?
That's the one thing I'm
good podcast. Fun questions to ask your friends.
Was that flavored?
Yo! Fun question to ask your friends.
Go Wes. Gimme Wes.
Yeah, that's cool. Here we go. What do you want? Here we go. Number one, what is the theme song of your life?
Interesting. Theme song of your life. Go. Just no explanation, just the name.
Lenny Kravitz, I want to get away. I have no idea. I want to get away. Because of my high school, I did a pep rally. It was my first magical performance in front of my high school as a magician.
Wow.
That's not really my life. But let me go around and I'll get a second answer because you guys got a chance to think about it.
I mean, off the top of my head,
no idea.
I would say Long Time Running, Tragically Hit.
Fuck. I'll go My Way, Frank Sinatra.
Nice.
You guys are going to know what I'm going to say. What band, though?
Yeah, Motley Crue.
For sure, but they're so... Kickstart My Heart, for sure. Yeah.
Kickstart My Heart, Motley Crue. Sure. All right, sure. Next question. So that's great.
All right, so... okay, if you could play a scene in a movie, what would it be?
Why are you miming sticking a dick? That was weird.
No, he was so mad at himself for having such a shit answer.
Oh, yeah.
Lenny Kravitz? Did his kid jump out of a window?
Yeah.
No, really? That was Eric Clapton.
What?
Is really?
Yeah.
Do you know how he died?
Oh my God, shit got so dark.
Yeah.
Alright, if you could play a scene in a movie, what would it be and which character would you play?
I got it. Easy.
Yeah.
Wolf of Wall Street, any of the scenes with Margot Robbie.
Oh.
Anyone.
Yeah, that's great.
Oh my God, fuck. If you go, you know what?
You're attracted to her?
Oh, it's my number one. Listen, no, she's so hot. If you go on these sites, I'm not a big like celebrity, like for the porn, you know, I'm a porn guy. I've never watched celebrity, I never watched movies.
I watch your Nesca.
No, you're good.
Okay, but if you go Wolf of Wall Street, there's 22 minutes on XNXX or on Pornhub that is like sexually explicit.
I saw it.
From the 2 hours of the movie, 22 minutes of like soft core, like blew my mind. Margot Robbie all the way. What about you? Wait, what was the question?
Yeah, I don't know anymore. Eric always makes this about him. You could play a movie character. If you could play a movie scene in a movie, mine would be, I would be in the new Saw movie.
you fucking because Chris Rock is actually in the new Saw movie.
But then I would be playing the role of Chris Rock.
Oh, cool.
Right.
And I'd be throwing my own self down.
What are you doing?
What a fucking weirdo. I would do. You know what I've always loved? I've always loved Matt Damon.
That's a big movie, man.
I like Matt Damon in Good Will Hunting when he doesn't show up all these meetings and then the NSA sits him down. He has this monologue to like, why don't you want to join the NSA? He's like, why don't I want to join the NSA? Let me take a crack at it. And he's like, let's say I do my job real well. And he just goes on this whole fucking tirade of how the NSA is all fucked. And for some reason, it just makes him sound so smart. So smart, I can't even do the monologue. That's how smart he is. And I'm like,
dude,
that
also when the dude's in the bar and he's just like spitting facts.
Oh, yeah. And he's like, oh, yeah, page 7. Yeah, I read that when I was in second year. You fucking.
You're making me regret my answer there.
Oh, so good.
Alex?
Molly Crew did not start it.
You know, but
Tommy Lee and Pamela Anderson.
Hot Tub Time Machine, Motley Lou.
Motley Lou. Actually, there's two, but one is Liam Neeson in Taken. I just love his fucking badass fucking moves, destroying people, but also saving his
John Wick.
John Wick too, but saving his like
his daughter.
His daughter, man. It's pretty cool, you know. So
dude. Don't make it weird. Don't make it weird. You know.
Yeah.
Why do you have to bring his
daughter? Why do you always have to fuck
weird? I have a big heart. What might you say?
A big what?
A big heart.
A big art?
A big art.
What is the funny... No.
Come.
You guys are being weird. Oh, sorry, I guess.
Let's do one more.
All right, one more from down here. If you...
What is the one thing you'd like to cross off your bucket list this year?
Dude.
We talked about it today. Dude. May I go first?
Yes, absolutely.
One thing, when I was a kid, one thing I wanted to cross off my bucket list was experience weightlessness, and we talked about something today.
What is that? Anorexia, or you have to go to the space camp. Those are the only two ways to be weightless.
Anyways. What the hell is that?
Oh.
Is that a tooth?
Sorry, the people just listening. A lot of sight gags going on here, and Alex's head is bigger in person.
Okay.
I know it sounds big.
Here we go.
Alex.
I move back so his head looks. Yeah. Like, I have to move way forward for my head to look anywhere near his size.
But I'll say it.
Eric wants to experience weightlessness.
It's not even true.
Okay, you want to experience weightlessness? And so,
And have the show to pay for it, you know?
Obviously.
Yeah.
What was it?
Not true.
Weightlessness. Say it again.
What was it?
Unaccountable.
Oh, sorry.
Unaccountable?
Little weightlessness.
Little way.
I have a big art, so, you know. How about you, bud?
Cross off the bucket list this year. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna think about it for a second.
Okay, I will put, because this year's so different than
everything. It is,
so it's hard. I would say, I would like to...
I can answer for both of you.
What do you think?
Well, okay, yeah, Eric. No, Eric.
I'll answer for both of you.
I have one.
Okay, you have one.
No, wait, go for it.
I would say you like getting a show.
Yeah, but I feel like that's happening.
That's too okay. And I was gonna say Chris getting an EP credit. That's a huge, huge.
Yeah, but not a bucket list thing.
For me, I mean,
not a bucket list thing. Then why are we doing this?
I would like to.
No, the bucket list thing is being on a show with you guys, but the EP thing is just like something I have to do.
Well, I would like to see this channel get up to 250,000 subs. That for me is a big year thing.
Building a barrel.
What are you at right now?
Building a barrel. 182. Right.
Push boys. And then, but also I would like.
I'm sure you'll get there one day.
I would honestly like. Subscribe. Yeah. Okay. I'd like to see Alex go. That's one of the things I want to cross over bucket list. No, I let you go.
Can you leave?
Oh, okay. Honestly,
maybe.
Check.
Maybe. Obviously, to have my own show with you guys, but that the show works and the spectators and the audience likes it.
Yeah, that would be weird. That's a weird bucket list.
It's an easy
one. And that's, what do you want to check that off your bucket list? Like, your bucket list would be like flying an air balloon.
You have to go talk to
everybody. That's what I want.
You're like, oh, I want my bucket list to be all the spectator in the world to be happy and in love.
Today?
That's not a bucket list.
Oh, actually, okay.
Skydiving.
Alex, another one.
Guys. Fucking the airplane with the
fucking airplane.
Weightlessness.
Cool.
Yeah, I say that's like a tangible thing. It's like a boom.
Chris, you and I have the same. I think we all have the same goal too. We all want to see Alex's dick this year. No one's seen it.
Well,
I've seen all your dicks.
Chris faced it though.
Alex hides his shit when he pisses around us.
Like, we're boys.
For years. For the last 10 years, Alex, you know, as a guy, if you're a guy, you know, you're not showing off. Like, I'm an exhibitionist. I like whipping it out. But if you're in a urinal with somebody, you're going to hide. With your friends.
This video is not going to age well.
Yeah.
All I'm saying is that
this video is 18 year old.
Yeah, but it's not going to age well.
It's legal.
Hey!
What's up, buddy?
We're just filming this.
Dude,
like literally
minutes,
nobody there.
7 minutes.
All right.
There's nobody. It's just so crazy.
Oh my god.
Empty fucking room. Oh my god. If you have made it this far, I appreciate it very much.
Okay, mine is creating a puzzle. As lame as that sounds, that's been a bucket list for a couple years now. And so I'm in the process of doing that. Mm. That's my bucket list for this year.
Mine's also building you a puzzle. Since we started talking about it, I've been horny about it. I was going to do it before we got here, but I got bogged down trying to make my other YouTube stuff. But I'm 100% doing it in our break. That's my main goal. It's going to be fucking awesome.
Can't wait.
I've lost sleep over this goddamn puzzle.
Damn, dude.
I'm so excited.
I can't wait to get all the views.
Oh, dude, I can't wait for you to be like this. Because I literally can't wait for you to be like this. This is a puzzle? And then just like open it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, That took me 6 weeks.
I can't wait to be like, yeah. Wes, do you mind if we just make an Instagram story?
Or purposely break it and be like,
Like, oh, this will be a great.
Yeah, look at TikTok. Is fine.
Wes shows up with this
a reel. Can I make it a reel?
Weeks on it.
15 seconds.
Chris is like, oh, yeah, for sure. This will be a great story.
Yeah, it's gonna be a great reel.
I'll tag you in it.
He's like, if it's good, it'll go up on Wednesday. If it's bad, Friday. I'm like, what if it's really bad? And he's like, you'll know. That's so weird. Eric is like, do you like doing magic? That's good.
Yeah.
Okay, that's nice.
What was that?
That's fancy.
How do you do that? Tutorial right now.
Yeah. Tutorials one of the lore.
I feel like all you guys do is just make fun whatever I bring to the table.
Well, yeah.
It's not bad. Let's see. Do it again.
I fucking caught you.
What do you
That's pretty good though.
For those listeners, there's only not very many of you, which is good.
Eric's, you don't think this is not a typical, so what's different from this
podcast?
Well, it's because we got to vocalize what it is you're doing.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people listen on
iTunes.
iTunes or Spotify?
Yeah.
I'm feeling that the table is like...
Yeah, the table slowly getting closer to the camera and mic, which might make for better audio.
This is a very terrible episode for you to listen to. It's very cacophonic.
Yeah.
Is that a like,
yeah, yeah.
Cacophonic.
Yeah.
It's cacophonic.
And there's too much chaos.
Okay.
Visually, and too much chaos, you know, for your ears.
So, Chris and I will do the next one by ourselves where we can actually make it sound good.
Yeah, we might keep this one for a rainy day.
This one's gonna go up tonight.
Oh, really?
I'm putting it up right now.
Yeah, heck yeah.
Fuck it. We missed you guys this week because we've been coming here and trying to do this thing. So we're trying to miss them, but when we do, you know it's not because we don't love you, it's just because we're fucking busy sometimes. And we'll see you on the next one.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a nice way to sound, Doc? I feel like that's very sincere. I mean all that.
Yeah, dude.
Well, hey, I fucking love you guys. Thanks for coming out. Bottom of the barrel, we love you. Chris loves you even though he's on his phone right now.
This is such
Bob
bullshit.
Loves you. We'll see you next time.
Bullshit.
Comment your middle name. Be cringe.
Peace out, guys.
And they're leaving. All
right.
Down in the barrel, there's a naked man. A stupid drunk with a bottle in his hands. Along came a brother from